Good morning, everybody. Was that loud? I have these in. I can hear myself. I don't know what it sounds like out there, but anyway, it's good to see you. We're excited that you're here this morning. Had a good Sunday school class over next door, and a lot of good teaching from the Bible over there. I'm sure it was the same way over here. Good to see everybody this morning. You're here for a reason. And we hope that you'll worship in spirit and truth this morning. So I want to welcome you, and we'll have a chance for you to get to welcome everybody here in just a little bit. But also want to open up the floor for any announcements that we need to share with our church. We'll have a few prayer requests that we need to be lifting some folks up as well. So I know we've got a, I think Brent was telling them that was the space for special music there. And they said if they were going to do the special music that, the doors would swing both ways. You know, there'd be so many people running out of here. But I think Mel and Cindy's going to come and just make an announcement. They're not going to be doing any singing this morning. All right, so we'll call on you guys. And anybody else that might have an announcement, we'll let you make that as well.
We just wanted to talk about last Tuesday night, we had a women's meeting, and we had 27 ladies show up. So we were so tickled with that. I don't know if it was the Chick-fil-A that brought everybody out, but we had a really good meeting, and we are having another one in May the 28th, so we would like for y'all to let us know if you can come. We are tickled to death with all the attendance, and it's really it's a blessing to have all the ladies come. So,
yeah, and also we're going to start a secret sister again, and you don't have to come to the ladies' meeting to participate in that. If you would like to do secret sister, you can see me, Sandy, or Jessica, and we'll be glad to get you all signed up and get you involved. Thank you all, and like she said, thank you all for coming. It was wonderful to see that many ladies come out.
Thank you all. Will there be other announcements that we want to share this morning? I know that we did have some prayer requests in our Sunday school class this morning. I'll mention a few of those, and then maybe there's others. Megan's dad, Chris Souter, scheduled to have some surgery for a hip replacement. That's right, hip replacement. It's going to be a little bit off, but they're doing some preparatory work for that. And then we need to be remembering her grandmother as well, Carol Souter. That's getting some rehab right now for some things that she has. So just be praying that that goes as well as it could. David Gregory, that Brother Leland's mentioned several times, still stands in need of our prayers. And some of you know Jay and Regina Hansford, right? I think they're stockyard related. Is that correct? A lot of people know them from the stockyard. This is C.V. Hansford's parents, right? Okay. I think Jay has some pneumonia and some other issues going on, needs our prayers there. I've got a friend of mine, Rick Keltner, that's been on the prayer list for a little bit, going through a lot of difficulty right now health-wise, tugs on my heart. Not sure he's a saved person. If I can get to him, I'll have a conversation with him for sure about that. Others that might need our prayers. Wow. A lot of prayer needs this morning. Others maybe that, I know Sherry, your brother, and has come through his surgery good, and we're thankful about that. Yes. Anybody else? Leland? Oh, my goodness. Wow. Yes. I'm sorry. Charlie Davis. Oh, really? Wow, my goodness. So if you think about it, I was thinking about it this morning before I come to church. So the Lord knows all about our needs. We wouldn't even be here. We wouldn't be able to breathe, take a step, anything, if it wasn't for the Lord's grace and mercy that He has on us. We have needs in our church this morning and in our community that we need to be lifting up in prayer this morning. So if there's no others, yes. Yeah, Cotton. Cotton's so faithful to be in our services. Excuse me. So, Cotton Mercer. Brother Jack, I'm going to call on you. You're back in our fold again, and you know we've been missing you. I'm going to ask if you'll petition the Lord this morning for all these prayer needs in our services. Thank you. Thank you. I'm going to ask you to stand, and we're going to do a little bit of responsive reading this morning. It's very short, but it goes along with Brother Gerald's message this morning. I want to say personally, it does my heart good to see these families in church and coming and worshiping with us and soaking up what the Lord has to give to us and from the pulpit and from His Word. I'm going to ask you to turn to page 524 in your blue book. It's at the very back, 524, and we're going to be doing responsive reading number 573. This is taken out of Isaiah chapter 55, verses 6 and 7. You'll probably hear that even more today. We're going to do it twice. It's so short, but I want it to sink in with you when we do it. I'll read the non-italicized part, and then you chime in on the other. 524, responsive reading 573. Seek ye the Lord while He may be found, call ye upon Him while He is near. Let the wicked forsake his way, and the unrighteous man his thoughts, and let him return unto the Lord, for He will have mercy upon him, and to our God, for He will abundantly pardon. We're going to do it one more time, because sometimes when we do it once, it doesn't sink in all the way. So let's do it again. Seek ye the Lord while He may be found, call ye upon Him while He's near. Let the wicked forsake his way, and the unrighteous man his thoughts, and let him return unto the Lord, for He will have mercy upon him, and to our God, for He will abundantly pardon. This is Isaiah 55, 6 through 7. I'm going to ask you to turn to number 334 in the blue book. The words again will be up on the screen. This is Blessed Assurance. Jesus is mine. If you're saved, you have that assurance this morning that He's living down in your heart. It should be a good feeling, good happy feeling that you're on the Lord's side this morning. Blessed Assurance. Blessed Assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. Heir of salvation, purchase of God, born of His Spirit, washed in His blood. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Perfect submission, perfect delight, visions of rapture now burst on my sight. Angels descending, ring from above, echoes of mercy, whispers of love. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, and this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Perfect submission, all is at rest. I and my Savior am happy and blessed, watching and waiting, looking above, filled with His goodness and lost in His love. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. 491 is our next hymn. Do you like who you're sitting by, singing by this morning? Everybody like that? Yeah, we're going to all, if you're saved, you're going to get to heaven one day. Yeah, I see some over here kind of like wanting to switch around, but this is when we all get to heaven. We'll sing and shout the victory. So, you know, if you want to change it up, you better be doing it now. You might be, no, I say that kiddingly, but I love our worship, love our music that we sing. So let's all worship the Lord here when we all get to heaven. Think about it. We'll be up there singing in the heavenly choir. 491. Sing the wondrous love of Jesus, sing His mercy and His grace. In the mansions bright and blessed, He'll prepare for us a place. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory. While we walk the pilgrim pathway, clouds will overspread the sky. But when traveling days are over, not a shadow, not a sigh. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory. Let us then be true and faithful, trusting, serving every day. Just one glimpse of Him in glory will the toils of life repay. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory. Word to the prize before us, soon His beauty we'll behold. Soon the pearly gates will open, we shall tread the streets of gold. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory. we'll jump higher than those UK players can when they dunk the ball. When we get to heaven and see Jesus, I can pretty much assure you that for sure. We have been incorporating some contemporary music into our worship services, and I appreciate the ones that have suggested that and trying to align with that. I think I've been listening to them. They've got some great messages in those songs. I personally have not learned them well enough to lead you as well as I would like to. So anybody, young group, want to come up and sing this song? Anybody? Y'all want to come up and help lead it? Anybody? All right, I guess not. So I'm expecting you all to help us out here. So let's listen to this song, and I think hopefully it's got the words up there as well, but it does. So yeah, let's go ahead and play this. This should be Matthew West here.
I need a miracle. What's got you barely hanging by a single thread? What looks so hopeless now? What weighs down your heart without you? Beg for a breakthrough, but no sign of breakthrough yet. When you've cried and you've cried till your tears run dry, the answer won't come and you don't know why. And you wonder if you can bow your head even one more time. Don't stop praying. Don't stop calling on Jesus' name. Keep on pounding on heaven's door. Let your knees. Crushed in spirit, the Alpha and Omega knows how your story ends. When you've cried and you've cried till your tears run dry, the answer won't come and you don't know why. And you wonder if you can bow your head even one more time. Stop praying that addictions end. Don't stop praying for deliverance. Hallelujah, hallelujah, and amen. Oh, don't stop praying for the sickness healed. Don't stop praying for his power revealed.
About that, a lot of good words in that song. Don't stop praying. A lot of people need our prayers. We identified that this morning, but even beyond that, what that song says, don't stop praying. I appreciate y'all. Appreciate the young ones here and their music. We appreciate it. We're going to receive our mid-service offering this morning. We'll ask that our ushers come, and we'll pray for our mid-service offering. So this is the time to give your blessings and your tithes over to the Lord, and then After that, we'll have some special music in our message. So,
let's pray, folks. Dear Lord, just thank you so much for this day, Father. Lord, for the beautiful weather that you provided for us. Lord, just every blessing you give us each and every day, let us not take those for granted, Lord. Lord, just thank you for Brother Ashley, and just pray for him today as you hide him behind the cross and have your message delivered through him. May we open our hearts and minds, Lord, and receive it. And Lord, may this reflect on the offering here today that we can further your kingdom. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
I appreciate everybody that has a hand in our services, from the musicians all the way up to the top, running our sound and doing our graphics and whatnot up there. I want to do this song. It humbles me every time I sing it. I saw a post last night on Facebook, one of my friends that was an award winner. It took them 19 years to get to the place of an award. And they were reflecting on that, and they said that, one of the reasons that they were able to get up to that level was that they had put everything in the Lord's hands and followed the Lord and under His leadership, and He guided them. You don't always have to be at the top, but that's what we strive to do sometimes, is we think we can be a little bit better than somebody else. But, you know, the truth of the matter is we're nothing without the Lord. We can't even walk without Him holding our hand. I want to sing that song for you. Just listen to the words of it. It speaks to me every time. I can't even walk without Him holding my hand. I thought that number one would surely be, and I thought I would be what I wanted to be. I thought I would build on life's sinking sand, but I can't even walk without Him my hand. thought I could do. A lot on my own, and I thought I could make it all alone. And I've thought of myself as a mighty big man, but I can't even walk without him holding my hand. Lord, I can't even walk without him holding my hand. The mountain's too high and the valley's too wide. It's down on my knees where I learn to stand, because I can't even walk without him holding my hand. I think that I'll make Jesus, I'll make him my own. And from now on, when I'm in trouble, on his name I'll call. If I don't trust him, I'd be less than a man, because I can't even walk without him holding my hand. Lord, I can't even walk without you holding my hand. You see, the mountain's too high and the valley's too wide, but it's down on my knees where I learn to stand, because I can't even walk without you holding my hand.
Thank you, Steve. And that is true for all of us. I appreciate what's already been said here today. All of you who do what you do to make the work of the church and the work of the Lord go forward. A lot of people work behind the scenes, and not all of them get up here and are seen. And I'm not much to see. I know the expression, hide me behind the cross. It doesn't take much to hide me. But seriously speaking, I'm not worthy of standing up here, but I'm here because God called me to be. Turn with me, if you will, to Isaiah chapter 55. Isaiah chapter 55. Beginning with verse 1. Ho, everyone that thirsteth, come ye to the waters, and he that hath no money, come ye buy and eat, yea, buy wine and milk without money and without price. Wherefore do you spend money for that which is not bread, and your labor for that which satisfieth not? Hearken diligently unto me, and eat ye that which is good, and let your soul delight itself in fatness. Incline your ear and come unto me. Hear, and your soul shall live. And I will make an everlasting covenant with you, even the sure mercies of David. Behold, I have given him for a witness to the people, a leader and commander to the people. Behold, thou shalt call a nation that thou knowest not, and nations that knew not thee shall run unto thee because of the Lord thy God and for the Holy One of Israel, for he hath glorified thee. Seek ye the Lord while he may be found. Call ye upon him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake his way, and the unrighteous man his thoughts. Let him return unto the Lord, and he will have mercy upon him, to our God, for he will abundantly pardon. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways, saith the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. For as the rain cometh down, the snow from heaven, and returneth not thither, but watereth the earth, and maketh it bring forth and bud, that it may give seed to the sower and bread to the eater, so shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth. It shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish that which I please, and it shall prosper in the thing whereto I sent it. For ye shall go out with joy, and be led forth with peace. The mountains and the hills shall break forth before you into singing, and all the trees of the field shall clap their hands. Instead of the thorn shall come up the fir tree, and instead of the briar shall come up the myrtle tree, and it shall be to the Lord for a name, for an everlasting sign that shall not be cut off. Let us pray. Father, thank you for this time that you have given us together. Thank you for your salvation, for your forgiveness, for that relationship that is made available with you through the sacrifice and the victory of Jesus Christ, through faith in him. And Father, we pray that you would help us to commit ourselves afresh this day, to speak your word, to glorify you by the things that we do each day, and that we might draw others to Jesus. And Father, even in this service today, may there be those that open their hearts to Jesus and know that wonderful feeling of having sins forgiven and that place prepared for them in heaven. And Father, may your will be done in each of our lives. Open our hearts, we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Everyone that thirsteth, come ye to the waters. Did you ever get thirsty? How long can you go without water? Not very long. It's a basic need. Did you ever get hungry? Yes. We think we have. I've probably never been hungry. I thought I wanted something to eat several times a day. But I've probably never been hungry like some people in the world are today. But we are accustomed to going and getting what we need, whether it's water or something to eat. But Jesus is talking about something far more important to our future than H2O or bread. He says, why do you spend money for that which is not bread, and your labor for that which satisfieth not? There is a basic need in every human being, every creation of God, for that relationship with God. He made us to need him. And if we're not entirely comfortable, if we're missing something, we think it's probably God. Because just as we have that basic need to go get some water or to get something to eat, we have a basic need for God that only he can satisfy. And some people think, well, if I could just be a great sports figure, I would have it made. Or if I could just have this kind of house, or drive this kind of car, or have this kind of beauty or looks, I'd have it made. And they get that, and not only does it not satisfy, but even at that point it doesn't last. Houses wear out. Someone was remarking, may have been this morning, I don't remember recently, about the number of houses that are around that used to be beautiful houses being in use. Now they're run down, the fields, the yards grown up. Houses wear out. Cars wear out. That's why there's trying to sell you another one. But they wear out. The beauty fades. The looks fade. The energy fades. The ability to do things disappears. If you're young, you may not be aware of that, but the time's coming. There's only one thing that is lasting, and that is God, and those that have chosen Him, they will get to, well, let me rephrase that. Every person lasts forever, but some get to do it with God in a place called heaven, and some get to do it in a place called hell. But once we have been created of God, we're going to be somewhere forever. And it's very important that we choose that which satisfies, which meets our need. We could take a drink of water because we know we need it. I need one every now and then because my throat gets drying out on me. We get some food because we know that we need it. We need to realize that our greatest need is for God. He says, incline your ear and come unto me. Incline your ear. Now, talking about getting older, the hearing is not as good as it used to be. And I've been told that I have selective hearing. Any of you been told that? And I don't hear as well as I used to. Becky doesn't either. The TV is usually up so loud that I can't understand exactly what she said to me. And sometimes I hear something totally different. But what he's pointing is focus on what I'm saying. Focus on what I'm saying to you. What's God saying to you this morning? What's He want to do with your life that you've not been allowing Him to do? You'll never be happy until you do what God wants you to do, to you where He wants you to be. Incline your ear, come unto me, hear, and your soul shall live. Your future is in God. He says, I will make an everlasting covenant with you, even the sure mercies of David. God had made a promise to David that a descendant of his would be on the throne forever. And that's referring to Jesus coming. But he says, reading on down here, he says, I have given him for a witness to the people, a leader and a commander to the people. Thou shalt call a nation that thou knowest not, and nations that knew not thee shall run unto thee because of the Lord thy God and the Holy One of Israel, for he hath glorified thee. He may be obviously speaking about his people, the Jewish people, but whenever we turn to God, it gets people's attention. God blessed America. And people from all over the world wanted to come to America and wanted to do what America wanted them to do. It's ceasing to be that way because we have turned away from God and He is withdrawing His hand of blessing from us. We're still blessed, but not to the degree that He used to or that He wants to today. But if we will incline our ear unto Him and listen to Him, America can be great again. I'm not talking politically, I'm talking about spiritually. That's how it comes. We can be. He says, seek ye the Lord while He may be found. There will come a time that is too late. Too late. And what a terrible thing to know that you messed up and it's too late. I'm sure if you look back in your life, you can find a time when there was a decision that you made too late to get the benefit of whatever you were thinking about at the time. Whether it was something you wanted to buy or someplace you wanted to go, too late. But there's something far more important, and that's your eternal destination. You need to choose that now before it's too late. Seek ye the Lord while he may be found. Call ye upon him while he is near. Now the beauty of God's love is that as long as there's that last breath, it's not too late. But once you've taken it, then it's too late. There was a man in the Flatler community that was a lost man. He was a good man. He was a lost man. His wife, faithful member of church, we prayed for him. He didn't want to talk about being saved. He would change the subject immediately if you started to get into it. But the day that he died, he finally gave in and trusted Jesus Christ as his Lord and Savior. It's not too late, but you don't know when you're going to die. And so seek him now while he may be found. Call you upon him while he's near. He says, let the wicked man forsake his way, and the unrighteous man his thoughts, same idea, and he will have mercy upon him to our God, for he will abundantly pardon. God promises, all we have to do is ask, and he will forgive. But it has to be while we're still alive, and we just don't know. We're all one heartbeat away from eternity. He says, my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are my ways your ways, saith the Lord. Now, most of us think our way's pretty good. It's not. Unless we're walking with God, it's not a good way. Now, we can plan out our lives and plan out our careers and plan out all these things, but we better just let God take us one step at a time, one day at a time. It's okay to plan, as long as God is the center of that plan. He says, for as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. Verse 11, so shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth, it shall not return unto me void, but shall accomplish that which I please. God, when he created this world and then created everything that's in the world and created mankind, he knew what a mess was going to happen, but he had a plan for it. He had a plan. He knew there would be evil, but he wanted to show his love. He wanted to redeem people. And it's a marvelous thing that he has come up with. There's no one in here better than anyone else. All those that are saved, yes, they're good, but they weren't saved because of what they did. They were saved because of what Jesus did, and they accepted the truth of it. They believed in the sacrifice that Jesus made for them on the cross of Calvary. That's the only way. And I'll never be better than anyone else. You'll never be better than anyone else. But we need to let the world know, all those around us, that God loves them, that he wants to have that relationship with them. He wants them to be with him in heaven. The scriptures tells us that Jesus, for the joy that was set before him, endured the cross. That cross was no picnic, as you saw in the video that was displayed here. And I'm sure that, as bad as that was, it didn't do it justice. As he went through all that, his motivation was getting to be with you and me in heaven forever. The joy that was set before him, he endured the cross, despising the shame. And his word will not return back to him void. He didn't get tricked by anything that happened. He knew all that was going to happen. He knew everything that you've ever done. before you did it. He knew every thought you've ever had before you think it. And we could go on and on with that. And you may say, well, how important is some of that information? It's very important, because if he didn't know every bit of it, he wouldn't be all-knowing. And God is all-knowing. God knows how many atoms there are in the universe. God knows how many birds there have ever been and ever will be, how many flies and how many mosquitoes there have ever been and ever will be. God knows all these things. He is an infinite, to some people, unbelievable God, but he is real, and we better believe in him. His ways are above ours. And he promises a beautiful thing. Instead of the thorn shall come up the fir tree, instead of the briar the myrtle tree, and it shall be to the Lord for a name, for an everlasting sign that shall not be cut off. Growing up on the farm, I would like to have had those thorns and those briars not be around to have to chop out. And I sometimes used to be upset with Adam for messing it up when we could have had everything so nice. But that wasn't part of God's plan. But God has got a wonderful thing prepared for each and every one of his children if we will just incline our ear, listen to him, let him have his way, accept his gift of forgiveness, acknowledge our need for that gift, acknowledge our sin, trust him, and he will save. And he will bless, and you'll be eternally grateful that you inclined your ear, that you listened at the right time. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for being such a good, loving God. Thank you for knowing us. Thank you for knowing what we need, even when we might think it's something else. And thank you for giving us the opportunity to acknowledge our need and to come to you. Be with each one here this morning. Help us to listen to your Holy Spirit and to your word and to obey. In the time of commitment, we pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
But I ask that we all